Favorite movie?
Oh no, I hate it when people ask this question.
That is such a big question.
My favorite changes so much over the years.
You know what? This is going to surprise you.
I think my favorite movie is the original Total Recall. It's very predictable. It includes Mars. It includes political philosophy and a society being tyrannized because someone's controlling their oxygen. It's actually a pretty interesting movie. I mean, it's a crazy movie, and it's got a lot of violence in it, actually, it has to be said.
My favorite movie is probably, I'm not a huge movie person, but I think I would probably say The Fifth Element.
I would have to say The Fifth Element because it's the one sci-fi movie that if it's on, I will watch it regardless of how many times I've seen it.
It's really funny. It's a good movie. It's a bit cheesy, but I think that's the point.
A fun take on the future, and it's twisted and weird, and I love it.
I always start to think of like Christopher Nolan movies because that's what I've done some work on. I mean, I'm a huge Memento fan. Would I want to say it's my favorite movie? I don't know. But I got a lot of time for Memento.
I think my favorite is Contact. Contact.
It is Contact.
Contact is my favorite. Actually, on Christmas, I rewatch. I watch again this movie because it's amazing. Because it's other time, but it's a current topic.
My favorite movie is Gosford Park. and I don't even totally know why. When I first saw it, I didn't like it because I just kind of didn't get it. But for some reason, I kept watching it, and it has become just pure comfort for me that there are a lot of characters, there are a lot of beautiful dresses, there's a lot of strife that doesn't matter, and then a couple of people who are more grounded, and a lot of them are very beautiful, and it just is where I go when I need to feel a little better.
I usually say it's the 1959 version of the Time Machine, H.G. Wells' Time Machine. I just love that as a teen, as a youngster, because the main character had such an obsession with time and trying to change the course of events. There are, in a way, philosophical questions that are addressed in the beginning and end. You talk about, you know, a golden record. They said, what three books would you take with you if, you know, you were running to the machine to go back to the future? Ironic term. And, you know, what three books from your library would you take that could most distill the essence of humanity? I mean, that was just, I thought that was incredible.
My favorite changes so much over the years. For a long time, it was Star Wars. I saw Star Wars when I was 13, and it just seized my imagination. I guess I'm going to go with that because that's probably been my, I've had different favorites, but that's probably been my favorite for the longest amount of time.
At the moment, I just love all Marvel movies. So currently love The Eternals. It's a great movie. It's beautiful. Oh, it's fantastic. But...
Martian, The Martian. Of course, The Martian. It's because I cried so much when I saw it, and I just wanted to be there. There is a beautiful Carl Sagan quote that also I cried when I first read. And it says, whatever the reason you're on Mars, he ends with, and I wish I were there with you. Oh my God.
Blade Runner, to this day, is still my favorite. My second favorite of all time was Dune, the 1984 version. The new Dune has supplanted that. I love that film. So it's probably not edging out my number one. Blade Runner is probably always going to be my favorite, but those two would be it, yeah.
Not even close to science fiction. The Keira Knightley Pride and Prejudice. I read the novel, then watched the movie, then read the screenplay, then watched the movie again, the screenplay. So it was like a week and a half of just Pride and Prejudice. And I just thought, what a work of art. Like, they just took this already awesome book and they just translated it into this beautiful thing. So much art in deciding what to include, what to kick out, what to interpret differently. But yeah, that's currently my number one, Pride and Prejudice.
This is right now, it's Solaris. based on a book by Stanislaw Lem. I'm talking about the version with George Clooney. The whole vibe of the movie was very, it was surreal, but kind of edgy at the same time. You know, all these dead people coming back to life in the space station far away from Earth was also very interesting. But at the very end, one of the characters says, "We don't have to think like that anymore." And that really got to me because I realized that it was how limiting it is to think the way we do as humans. Our beliefs are so, what we believe in, they're so finite. And the universe is full of possibilities. So, you know, it's like we mentally tie ourselves down when we don't have to.
My favorite movie is Aliens, starring Sigourney Weaver, because I saw it when I was far too young to watch it, and it completely changed the way I looked at science fiction. From going from Close Encounters of the Third Kind to Aliens was a huge mental jump, and I don't think I'd be writing the kind of science fiction I write today if I hadn't seen that film.
The Sound of Music. One reason that I love The Sound of Music is because it is a story about love, and it's about overcoming extraordinary adversity in a very dangerous time. And I think it's always resonant, and particularly right now. It's an example of being open to possibility, to new experiences that you hadn't planned for in life. Like Maria, you know, was a nun. She wasn't looking for taking on a big family, you know. It's just such a touching and lovely movie, and about family and love.
I like The Arrival.
Well, that would be Arrival.
Arrival.
Arrival was
my most favorite movie.
Yeah, Arrival would be number one.
I mean, aside from the fact that it's based on a phenomenal Ted Chiang short story.
I really enjoyed reading about the short story where the movie came from.
It is a really, really good alien first contact story with really alien aliens. Yeah, they're not sort of human-looking, come-in-peace aliens. They are properly bizarre, baffling aliens, and the whole film is about.
Yeah, and the whole way in which they tried to communicate, they found a way of communicating with them, it was really nice.
It's very fascinating how, even if we encounter another species, then how communication is shaped. If we think about our own species, the human, the communication is already very different among all of us, because we have different languages, and already the idioms that characterize for this, for example, the Asian cultures are very different in the way that they express their thoughts.